वेलकम टू साइफिलिक एकेडमी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर चैप्टर इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस डेवलपमेंट्स लीडिंग टू बोहर्स एटॉमिक मॉडल। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 7। सो फ्रेंड्स, एज ऑफ नाउ टिल आवर 6th लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सेवरल एटॉमिक मॉडल्स एंड इन द प्रीवियस डिस्कशन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट रदरफोर्ड्स एटॉमिक मॉडल एंड इट्स ड्रॉबैक्स। एज we will just have a glimpse of Rutherford's atomic model. Rutherford's atomic model was like a planet, hence it is called as planetary model also. In this model he explained that electrons are revolving around the central positively charged nucleus, and the main drawback with this model was any charged body in its accelerated state emits energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations, and if electrons are moving in these circular orbits like this, then what would have happened? According to Maxwell's theory, these electrons while revolving, they must have taken a spiral path and they must have coincided with the nucleus, resulting into unstable atom. But we all know that atoms are relatively stable, and because of which you, me and all matter exists. Hence this model couldn't be possible was clear from this Maxwell's theory. One more thing with Rutherford's experiment and Rutherford's model was that he didn't speak anything about the energy of electrons and distribution of electrons around the nucleus, how electrons are distributed around the nucleus. He failed to explain about the energy of electrons and distribution of electrons around the nucleus. So, Sir Rutherford started his experiment in 1909 and reached up to his model in 1911 AD. Up to this research, several theories and several discoveries were happened in scientific world. Sir Niels Bohr utilized these inventions and proposed his model. He developed and amended Rutherford's model utilizing these discoveries. We will move on to the discoveries later. First we will have a glimpse of Sir Niels Bohr's atomic model. What he said: indeed, electrons are not stationary and revolving around the nucleus, but electrons are not revolving randomly around the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus only in those orbits for which angular momentum is integral multiple of h by 2 pi, where h is Planck's constant. What he said, electrons indeed are revolving around the nucleus, but electrons won't revolve in any random orbit. They revolve only in those orbits for which angular momentum is integral multiple of h by 2 pi, where h is Planck's constant. So friends, for proposing this atomic model theory, what all discoveries guided and helped Niels Bohr was, very first and most is ड्यूअल नेचर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस. आई विल राइट EMR फॉर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस. ड्यूअल नेचर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ वेव पार्टिकल ड्यूअलिटी. एंड एक्सपेरिमेंटल रिजल्ट्स ऑफ इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रा और एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा. These two important theories and discoveries help Sir Niel Bohr to reach from Rutherford's model to his atomic model. And how, in addition to that, this was the time of discoveries of various electromagnetic radiations like X-rays, gamma rays, even this was the time of study of radioactivity. So several research was going on and several theories and inventions came out in this time, which led Niel Bohr to reach his atomic model. So friends, this was brief about Niel's atomic model, Niel Bohr's atomic model. He proposed this model in 1913. After 2 years of Rutherford, he studied all the theories and correlated with this atomic model and took 2 years to propose this model. And the most important theory, dual nature of electromagnetic radiations, which helped Niel Bohr to reach this model, we will discuss it. Now, in that, first we will look at wave nature of electromagnetic radiations. So friends, we will see what is dual nature of electromagnetic radiations. Friends, any charged body, when you take any charged body, let's say electron or anything, when any charged body is accelerated, it emits energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations. What exactly it means? When this charged body is accelerated, it produces electric and magnetic fields in surrounding area, and these electric and magnetic fields are transmitted in the form of waves. So friends, and in addition to that, these electric and magnetic fields propagate in the mutually perpendicular directions. We will see the picture of this. So we can write in this way. Electromagnetic radiations have both dual nature, that is, have both characters of particle as well as wave. Now we are discussing wave nature of electromagnetic radiations. When charged bodies are accelerated, they produce electric as well as magnetic fields in the surrounding area, and these electric and magnetic fields are transmitted in the form of wave in mutually perpendicular directions. Let's say this is the charged body, this is Z axis, this is Y axis, and this is X axis. I will extend this for our better understanding. This will be the y-axis, this will be the x-axis, and this will be the z-axis. So friends, if we see in this way,
this is the x axis, this is the y axis, and this vertical is z axis. Now if electric field is generated, if it is moving in, let's say, xy plane, and which will be the xy plane, this horizontal plane will be the xy plane, this is x axis. So the electric wave will pass in this way, in horizontal direction, and this is z plane, and magnetic field will propagate perpendicular to this electric field, so this will propagate in z x axis, so in this way that movement will be in the vertical and downward direction. It will be in upward plane, that is z plane, moved downwards, and it will reach x axis and go below the x axis. So friends, this is the way in which electric and magnetic fields move, and propagation of wave will be perpendicular to these two fields, that is all the three are mutually perpendicular. Now we can draw xy plane on the board in this way. This is y plane, so xy plane will be like this, and the wave let's say in xy plane represents wave from electric field, so this will move like this. This is y axis, so let's say this wave is starting from this place, so this will wave will move like this. And let's say xz is representing wave due to magnetic field, so this will move in xz plane, and xz plane will be like this, so this wave will be like this, and wave will propagate in this direction, x direction. So this is the way in which electric wave due to electric field and wave due to magnetic field will transmit. And friends, if electromagnetic radiations have wave nature, means it must be associated with few properties of wave, like if this is the wave, if we deal with wave, we must know what is wavelength, what is frequency, what is wave number. So friends, any wave will propagate like this, in this form, and this upward part is called as crest, and this is called as trough. This is crest and next will be trough. So distance between any two consecutive crests or troughs will be same, and that is called as wavelength of that wave, and that is called as wavelength of that wave. This is one cycle of this wave. How many cycles are there in 1 second? How many cycles are formed in 1 second is called as frequency of that wave, is called as frequency of that wave. And number of waves per unit length, let's say 1 meter or 1 centimeter, number of wave in per unit length, number of waves per unit length is called as wave number, and the relationship between wavelength, frequency and wave number is with speed of light. That is, speed of light c is equal to frequency into wavelength lambda, and wave number is reciprocal of wavelength. Wave number is reciprocal of wavelength. So friends, wave number is reciprocal of wavelength, and from this equation we know that lambda is c by mu. So wave number is mu by c, that is frequency divided by speed of light. And friends, it is considered that all electromagnetic radiations are moving with speed of light, that is 3 lakh kilometer per second. So friends, I hope this is clear to all of you in this session. What we have seen, we began with drawbacks of Rutherford's atomic model, how Rutherford explained his planetary atomic model and how it is failed. Since any charged particle, when it is accelerated, it emits energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations, and if electrons are revolving in circular orbit around the nucleus in this way, then they must emit the energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations, and they will take a spiral path and they will coincide with the nucleus. And Rutherford sir didn't explain about the energies of electrons and the distribution of electrons around the nucleus. To overcome these drawbacks, Sir Niels Bohr proposed his atomic model and said electrons indeed are moving around the nucleus in circular orbits, but not in any random orbit. Electrons revolve only in those orbits for which angular momentum is integral multiple of h by 2 pi, whereas h is Planck's constant. So what all discoveries and what all experimental results take Sir Niels Bohr to this conclusion were two key theories. One is dual nature of electromagnetic radiations and experimental results of atomic spectra. Electromagnetic radiations like light were considered as particle in nature prior to Maxwell's theory. And all we know that light is considered as having particle nature, and light is made up of corpuscles. This corpuscle theory was collapsed due to this wave particle dual nature. And Sir Maxwell was the first to show experimentally that when any charged body is accelerated, it emits energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations. What are electromagnetic radiations? These charged particles when accelerated produces electric and magnetic fields, and these fields are transmitted in the form of waves, and these waves are of both types, that is electric and magnetic types. That's why these are called as electromagnetic waves, and these waves behave like waves as well as particles. These electromagnetic radiations have both the properties of wave and particle, and we have seen how this wave nature of electromagnetic radiations is. These electric and magnetic fields are mutually perpendicular to each other. Let's say a charged body is moving with different speed, that is, a charged body is not moving with constant speed, it is accelerated. When accelerated charged body is there, it emits energy in the form of waves, and these waves are mutually perpendicular to each other. Let's say if it is electric wave due to electric field, if it is moving in this direction like ZX plane, then magnetic wave due to magnetic field will move in XY plane, that is horizontal plane, and direction of propagation will be in this X direction. So these are the इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस वेव एंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड्स प्रोपेगेशन टाइप प्रोपेगेशन मेथड एंड इफ वेव इज देयर वेव इज एसोसिएटेड विथ इट्स प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक वेवलेंथ वेव नंबर एंड फ्रीक्वेंसीज वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज वेवलेंथ वेवलेंथ इज डिस्टेंस बिटवीन एनी टू क्रेस्ट और एनी टू ट्रफ्स एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज नंबर ऑफ साइकल्स दिस इज द वन साइकिल नंबर ऑफ साइकल्स पर सेकेंड इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दैट वेव एंड वेव नंबर इज जस्ट नंबर ऑफ वेव्स और नंबर ऑफ साइकल्स पर यूनिट लेंथ मे बी इट इज 1 centimeter और 1 meter दैट इज द वेव नंबर एंड वेव नंबर इज रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ वेव लेंथ एंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन वेव लेंथ एंड वेव फ्रीक्वेंसी इज सी इज इक्वल टू म्यू लैम्बडा frequency is represented by mu and wavelength is represented by lambda c is the speed of light all electromagnetic radiations are considered or all electromagnetic radiations move with speed of light that is 300,000 km/s and therefore this mu bar that is wave number will be equal to frequency divided by speed of light so friends this was about wave nature of electromagnetic radiations and in next session we will see particle nature of electromagnetic radiations thank you friends I hope you guys are enjoying with the sessions and if you have not subscribed to my channel I request you to subscribe the channel and share with your friends and friends in these videos I have to go with little slow pace because everyone from brilliant average and dull all types of students are watching these videos so I cannot increase my speed friends but you can forward the videos on YouTube you will find 3 dots on the right hand side from there you can choose the speed you can multiply the speed in the fractions 1.5 or you can double the speed as per your pace you can increase the speed okay friends Thank you. Best of luck.